software version 20.0. The categorical data was represented as frequency and proportions, whereas continuous quantitative data was expressed as mean and standard deviation. The analysis of the various factors was done using multivariate logistic regression analysis for independent associations. In my study, I found that out of the 450 subjects that I studied, 94 units had some ocular abnormality, which accounted for 20.89% of the units. Retinal hemorrhage was the most common ocular abnormality, and it occurred in 89.36% of those having some fundus binding. The delivery method had a significant impact on the incidence of neonatal retinal hemorrhages, and the p-value was significant, less than 0.021. Obstructed labor and neonates requiring resuscitation had higher incidence of retinal hemorrhages. Looking at the demographics of my study population, we studied it under two headings, that is normal ocular findings and abnormal ocular findings. The age and birth weight of the two groups had no significant differences, with an age of 1.74 days in the normal group and 1.98 in the abnormal group. The birth weight was not, there was no significant difference in the birth weight of the two groups. In the findings, most neonates having normal ocular findings, most were in the gestational age 39 weeks to 40 weeks. While those who had abnormal ocular findings, most were in the gestational age 37 weeks to 38 weeks. Looking at the gender distribution, those having normal ocular findings, most were males, accounting for 53%, while those with abnormal ocular findings, again most were males, 65% were found to have abnormal ocular findings for males. Coming to the risk factors amongst my study population, PIH, the newborns whose mother was suffering from PIH, 43% had developed some abnormal ocular finding, however it was not statistically significant. Coming to the mode of delivery, those delivered by vaginal delivery mostly had some abnormal ocular finding. Continuing to the risk factors, obstructed labor and those neonates requiring resuscitation had significantly higher abnormal ocular finding, abnormal fundus, mostly retinal hemorrhages in their fundus examination. Now, the various abnormal ocular findings that I encountered